Welcome to the UU Treehouse. I'm Stephen Mead and friends, here to tell another story this morning that we can have fun with and learn something from. Today's story is called Noah and the Rainbow Covenant. A covenant is a promise. It comes from the Tapestry of Faith series of Love Connects Us. Perhaps you have heard this story already about Noah and the flood. It comes from the Hebrew scripture, from the Bible, and it goes something like this. Did you ever make such a mess of your homework that you just got crazy mad and frustrated and wanted to crumple the whole thing up and you throw it away? Well, that's how God was feeling looking at the world. You pour your heart and soul into making this beautiful world full of people, animals, and plants. You think it's easy to get the stripes on the zebra just right? Well, and for what? Well, a year, two, or 1,500 go by and the whole thing's a mess. Mess, I tell you. People, what was I thinking? They're rotten to the core. They lie, they cheat, they steal, they murder. There's just not a decent one among them. Dang it all, I should just start over, obliterate the whole thing, and start from scratch. Yep. I think that's what I'm going to do. So God took a good look around just to make sure there were not, in fact, any decent people about to be destroyed. And it turned out that God found one good, clean living family, the family of a man named Noah. And so God went to Noah and said, "The world is just plain no good, and I'm planning on getting rid of all the people except you and your family. So this is what you must do. I want you to build a really big boat. Big enough not only for you and your family, but big enough for every kind of animal there is. And I'm going to give you time, but you better get on it because I'm going to rain this whole place out, and anyone who isn't on that boat is going to drown." Well, I imagine Noah had a hard time believing his ears. But he gathered up his family, told them what he heard, and they no doubt had just as hard time believing Noah as Noah had believing God. But they trusted him. And so some of the family went about building the boat, and the others went about collecting animals. Of course, everybody else thought Noah was just plain crazy. Just nuts for building this ginormous boat and filling it with animals. But Noah and his family just kept right on working. And eventually, the rain came and it rained and it rained and it rained and it rained like no rain you ever saw. It was as if the sky was full of thousands of fire hydrants and they all turned on at once. The water got higher, higher and higher, and the boat and the water covered the land, and the giant boat started to float, full of animals and Noah's family, gently rising with the water. And for days and days and nights, the rain went on, and it just finally stopped. The people ran to the windows of the ark. They were astonished to see blue sky and blue water. And nothing else. Just water and sky. There was nowhere to go and nothing to do. And so they waited. And they waited.
And they waited.
Finally, Noah sent a raven out, fly around and look for land. But he came back tired, for there was nowhere to rest. So he waited another week, and this time he sent a dove to fly out and around. But it just came back as tired as the raven. So he brought the dove back in, waited another week, and sent it out again. But this time the dove came back with a twig from an olive tree in its beak. Well, it found land. Well, eventually the water backed off enough for Noah to see the ark and come to rest on the top of a mountain. There was land all around them. maybe not dry land, you know, wet, mushy land, but it was land all the same. And finally the people and the animals were able to leave the crowded, smelly ark, well, and touch the earth. They were all overcome with gladness, and Noah made an altar to thank God for bringing them to safety. "Welcome home," says God. "I'm going to make a deal with you, a promise, a covenant. And my covenant is with not you, but just you, but all beings of the earth, not just the people. You go forth and populate the earth and fill it up again. And I promise never, never to flood the earth again. And as a sign of my covenant, I will put a rainbow in the sky. And every time you see a rainbow, it will remind you of our covenant to create and preserve life."